So inclusion body myositis is one of the main forms of inflammatory myopathy. So essentially a disease of the muscle whose main feature is inflammation or inflammatory cells if we look under the microscope. What we don't understand is whether it is actually an autoimmune process. So if the body is reacting against itself, seeing our own muscles as foreign in that disease, for example, or whether it's degenerative, where the muscle seems to age faster than would be expected, or a combination of both. The name inclusion body myositis comes from the fact that if you look under the microscope, you can often see what are called inclusions, which are little vacuoles or holes in the muscle. And while not all patients can have that finding, that's really the pathognomonic or sentinel finding that we look for in the muscle under the microscope. It's not entirely known how common the disease is, but the current estimates suggest it's about 7 for every 100,000 in the United States, which equals about 24,000 people that would currently be living with inclusion body myositis, which is also known as IBM in the United States. And interestingly, those estimates differ worldwide, with some countries having more and some countries having less folks that are affected with it. The disease affects more men than women, which is important because most inflammatory diseases in general affect women preferentially. So myositis taken as a whole affects about 3 to 1 women to men, whereas inclusion body myositis affects 2 to 1 men to women. It is in general an onset later in life. So most patients have the onset over the age of 50, and for the official diagnosis, patients must be over the age of 30. And the vast majority of our patients are considerably older than that.